There's a Quama we all know, who's as bold as any Dunmer. You can see by torch bulb's glow. Little Squib, she's such a wonder. Play, play, life's an adventure. Run, run, as fast as you dare. Sing,
the hour of our glory is nigh. Razum Dahl forewarned me of your coming, and I have considered our circumstances carefully in light of that. I have the utmost faith in your capabilities, and I am confident that your arrival is an augur of our victory. Indeed, we have fought alongside many of the same soldiers, and word travels quickly when it involves heroics such as those attributed to you. I have anticipated the chance to meet you in person, and I am pleased the opportunity has finally arrived. This, my friend, is the calm before the storm. Our storm. The Malma believe that holding hostages will prevent us from taking action, but we will not allow such cowardice to determine our course. We will act, and we will act decisively. We charge into their encampment, rescue the hostages, and slaughter their commanders. This full scout we captured gave us their locations. You and Razum Dahl shall spearhead our attack, one of you to handle the hostages, the other on the commanders. More brave soldiers arrive soon from Marbrook. We will rally them here and prepare to launch a full-scale attack. When your task is done, light the beacon in the lighthouse. That will be our signal to charge in and drive the bastards back to the sea. Olmian, Mayretel, and Bashira, all very influential in their own way. We need to ensure they're freed before we launch a full-scale attack. Husband of the Tree Thane of Woodhearth, Fariel. As good a fighter and tracker as any Wood Elf I've known. Just shows how Paladel caught even the best of us off guard. A respected noble from Somerset. She was on her way to Eldenroot to meet with the Thelmor. You might imagine the problems it would cause if something happened to her. Around here, they call him the Fat Cat. Wealthiest merchant in Woodhearth. But don't think his influence is limited to the city. Money moves, you know. More brave soldiers arrive soon from Marbrook. We will rally them here and prepare to launch a full-scale attack. The Maoma fight as a unit. Like a crew loyal to their ship's captain, the Maoma will follow the commander's orders without hesitance. Remove the commander and they will fall into disarray, at least long enough for our strike to overwhelm them. He's a prisoner of war, so he'll be treated accordingly, of course. Unless he tries to escape, in which case we'll bury him neck deep on the beach at low tide and let the sea decide his fate. The Maoma fight as a unit. Like a crew loyal to their ship's captain, the Maoma...
Little elf thought he could get away from Ablan. He was wrong.
You mean there's not going to be a hostage exchange? Dirt-eating liars! We'll kill you all and feed your remains to the seagulls!
Six are the walking ways. Enigma, enemy, teacher.
With you here, maybe I don't need to worry so much about getting my ship back from these cursed sea elves.
Come we now, their creatures, embody splendor in your name and wisdom.
Paladil will pay for what they did to Astro. They will all pay.
By the sword, I mean
time to do what we do best, yes?
By the
this should be fun.
I mean the dead. By the
excellent.
Sword, I mean
many opportunities for heroism, adventure, word, and thrilling tales dead. After the fact. So, my friend, what will it be? Will you tend to the hostages or take out their commanders?
Six are the guardians.
Dirty hands for dirty work. Raz will see to our captive friends, then. Stay out of sight if you can, or grab Larnil's armor. It's not fashionable, but you'll at least blend in. Always, Raz will see you at the lighthouse when our tasks are completed. Bright moons guide your steps.
March on through your bloody fight. Sing proud, sound roars, O ye buoyant armatures. Raise voices in courageous cheers. Give those heathens cause for fear. Stand tall, spoil wars, O ye buoyant armatures. Best their warriors by the score. Take a bow and best a dozen more. Set bones, some scars, O ye buoyant armagers. Where? Thank you.
Talqua is a...
Show you Gorath in South Point. The tales can't be true, can they?
What?
Selling, buying, trading, right here.
Welcome to Marbrook, jewel of Valenwood.
Strange happenings in the court of the Wilder King. Did you hear?
More Wilder King nonsense?
The Law of Meat.
Thank you.
God's mercy! What's going on? Why don't you just kill me? To let me linger like this? It's wrong. Wait. You're not one of them, are you? Where in oblivion am I? Who are you? Vice-Reeve Peladil. That monstrous bastard. He captured us in Woodhearth and brought us here for some evil ritual. He bled us, mutilated us. He ripped out our eyes. Gods, do I even look normal anymore? No, I'm not all right. I'm dying. And it's just as well. It was that bitch, Asteril's sister. She pretended to be Asteril and ordered us into the Imperial Underground. Then the Veiled Heritants ambushed us. They needed sacrifices for the ritual. They were raising Prince Naaman from the dead, bringing him back and imbuing him with some terrible power. Peladil kept talking about how the prince would lead an undead army, but I don't think it worked out the way he hoped. When Naaman came back, he wasn't the same. Sounded like some evil spirit was speaking through him. He spat in Peladil's face. Then he just left. Peladil was furious. He stormed out a little later. That's all I was able to hear. No. My eyes are gone. I'm probably scarred all over my body. Please. I just want to die. All I ask, just make them pay for this.